So how long were you in Puerto Rico for? Did you work down there for like colognes or anything like
so
that?
So I left right before. So I was in wrestling school there for 3 years. Mm-hmm. And I started doing smaller like companies down there. But then I quickly realized like at my size, it's going to be hard to really stand out and break out. Because back then, the scene was really hot. Not as hot as it was in the 60s, 70s, but they were still drawing like 10,000 people per.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, like is it the early 2000s?
No, then it was already on the decline. Okay. But
was it still a lot of like blood happening there still, at the time?
Yeah, for sure. Yeah.
Well, that's where the whole FMW style came from, was Puerto totally. Rico, right?
Yeah. So I realized I wouldn't be able to stand out the way I thought I could. So I actually moved to the States and just try my luck here. And then I moved to Florida and then joined Bubba and D-Von school. And that's when they taught me like the psychology of wrestling. I knew the moves. The moves are easy for me to learn because I'm a very visual learner. So if I see someone hook for a suplex, like I can probably understand how the mechanics of this. But what makes sense in a match and where to put that suplex, that's where I learned when I got to Bubba and D-Von school.
It's interesting that you'd already trained in Puerto Rico and you come to the States and enroll in school again. That takes a lot. You have to be humble to do that. I would never have done that.
Like started over.
Go in school again. Like, well, I know how to do all this shit.
Start over
completely. So what made you decide to do that?
I took a break. After I moved to Florida, I took a kind of a break because I didn't know where to go. Because back then, like wrestling school was still kind of hush-hush. I didn't really know what I wanted to do in life. And then by happenstance, I'm in a gym like near my house. And there's a banner that said, you know, Team 3 Academy opening soon. Like, what are the odds of like this happening to me, right? So I walked to the back and there's Bubba just sitting on his chair and just, what's up, kid? I'm like, oh boy, well, here we go.
Angry look on his face.
just angry for no reason. Like, sir, excuse me, sir, I want to just join pro wrestling school. He's like, are you sure? yes, sir. I was like, all right. And he explained everything to me. And 10 years later, you know, I was still there for a while. So I helped train the kids coming up after I graduated that school. And they're the ones that instilled, like, they found something in me that I didn't think I had, right? Mm. They said, hey, you're small. That's great. That's fine. There's nothing wrong with that. Now make it work for you. Mm. And that's what I ended up doing.
It's interesting when we, and we'll talk about it, when we had the 30th anniversary match of me and Hager against the Chaos Project. Bubba was texting me right when it was announced, like, that's good for this guy. He's a good kid. And he's, I mean, I didn't even call you a kid, but he's pretty solid and he deserves the chance. I was like, yeah, man, he sure does. So he was very proud of you.
Yeah, I owe them so much, and I say it every time I talk to them. Like they really like propelled my career forward. Like they gave me chances that other people probably wouldn't have given me. Right? Mm-hmm. Like there was one time I was still working at Target, and Bubba just texted me at like 7 o'clock at night. Hey, this weekend, do you wanna tag with us? Like, what? Tag with what? It's like, yeah, show up to Coral Springs High School down south of Miami at 8 o'clock on Saturday. I'm like, okay. And I showed up and tagged with them. It was great. And then they put me through a table. So, yeah, they got one over on me.
Who are you, Juan Dudley or something?
Yeah. Juan Dudley.
You know, and here we go. You know, just a couple months ago, you guys ended up working with D-Von's kids. TNT, Terrence and Terrell.
Yeah.
Which was hilarious because I try and watch as many of your matches as I can because I enjoy them. But I saw TNT on the board. So of course I'm thinking Savio Vega. I know it's a tag team, but who's TNT? And his name's been taken. And then I see the two kids. I'm like, wait a second. Last time I saw them, there was these two little guys just kind of looking around. I remember just like two little you know? So how was it for you to work with them?
It was great. I've known them for years. Cause they used to, while we were training in the ring, they would just show up with their dad and get in the ring and tumble around, and now to see them like, you know, come out on their own and have matches on in AEW was great. I enjoyed it. Lenny had never met them before, but I told them they're solid. Like, you haven't met D-Von yet, but they're just like their dad in the ring. Like, they move just like it'll be fun. And ended up being great.
It's easy.